and now I'm in the steamy age of menopause. Now I didn't even know what menopause was. I knew what it was, I just didn't realize that it could actually send you mad. I started to get hot flushes, and at first they were just, I'm just a bit hot, I lose some red wine. And then they just kept coming over and over again, and then they'd keep me awake at night, and they'd make my makeup run off my face during performances, and then they made my children think their mother had been invaded by a body snatcher. So I went to a gynecologist who explained what was happening and said it could take anywhere from between 2 years to about 15 years. So I was happy with that. Not! So I took HRT, but it didn't work for me. And anyway, where do all the old hormone patches go? Where do they go? Into landfill? That will eventually give us tomato plants the size of modern-day pigs? Or cows with PMT? Once a month they refuse to give milk and just want a bit of a weep in the back paddock? And where do the hormones we ingest and pass along end up? Sewage treatment plants like Werribee, Victoria? Well, that's not bad. Werribee is now a wonderful wetland which has produced some of the most powerful man-eating pelicans on earth. the hormones didn't work, and then a friend told me about Remifemin, which is a natural product. So I bought a packet and I threw them in my bag, and because they're natural, I would just swallow one when I thought about it, like a Tic Tac. That didn't work either. So I went back to the gynae who put me on to Livial, which is some sort of fake hormone, which made me feel so agitated, I thought I would pop. It is strange how we women study the backs of cereal to make sure we are not putting anything nasty into our systems, like too much sugar, and then we will pop every substance known to stop us sweating. Desperate, another friend also suggested Remifemin, so this time I took the suggestion seriously. I'm not a herbal person, but I went and talked to a professor about Remifemin and all the evidence that goes with it, and he upped the dose, and I took them regularly, and bingo, I felt fantastic. And I feel fantastic, and I get the occasional hot flushes, but they are not waking me up. Now they do really do feel like power surges. They do, and the children have their mother back again. Not a pod person, for those of you old enough to remember the body snatchers. I can smile and mean it. I used to just smile like this. What I really noticed going to menopause was that not many people talked about menopause. My mother, who would talk about anything, never talked about menopause. So I said to her, did you go through menopause? And she said, oh my God, it was the worst 5 years of my life. And I said, why didn't you talk to me about it? She told me about labor. I thought that was the worst 5 years of her life. And that was only her labor with me. According to mum's stories, her labor always lasted about 5 years. It involved tongs and machinery, anyway. But it's certainly, menopause is certainly not talked about publicly, which is strange, given that menopause is almost an epidemic now. It is the menopause epidemic. Why isn't it getting the attention it deserves? We have a well-documented aging population. 70% of our population is aging. The other 30% are evidently getting younger and younger. These figures are supplied by the United Nations. Most of the aging population are boomers. They are now in their 50s, a menopausal Vesuvius rumbling. Now, at first glance, the symptoms seem relatively benign. Women miserably shuffling around the shops, fanning themselves, or hunched at the gym, wringing out their underwear. or back at home, flinging back the doona and screeching at their husbands, "I hate the way you breathe when you eat." Harmless, perfectly harmless. But then think of all the mature women now finally in positions of power. The women around the boardroom table, voting for anything as long as someone opens a freaking window or turns on the air conditioning. Perhaps power baker Gail Kelly was having a moment when she left St. George's with all their secrets in her handbag and took over Westpac. Did something make her snap? Perhaps someone at work used her mug. Think of all the women having hot flushes in Parliament. Look at all those menopausal women fanning themselves with bits of white paper, voting on anything to get the hell out of the heat. And don't even think about the new caring, inclusive armed services. Women become generals and admirals and air marshals in charge of every fearsome weapon available at exactly the age when, at random, any time, any place, they will want to kick something. Or in their case, carpet bomb it. The dog, a husband, a neighbouring state, New Zealand. On the bright side, menopausal women have a unique insight into global warming, long before people did. Perhaps the planet is simply going through the change, and the ice age is just around the corner. I feel, though, sincerely, it's really important to talk about menopause, because for the first time, when I went to my local pharmacist, something happened that made me feel a little bit uncomfortable. And all the lovely and discreet ladies, when I went up to them and said that I was having hot flushes, they looked at me and they whispered, "Oh, precious. Hot flushes." Actually, they didn't whisper it, they mouthed it. They went. And it made me realize that it was something that women hide, that women feel embarrassed about. Or perhaps they were just trying to keep me calm. So my mission is to bring menopause out of the closet, where we keep our gin for our midlife life crisis. We need to talk about menopause openly and confidently. It's the last frontier for women's lib, and it really is liberating. My God, no more forking out for sanitary products. We can now play tennis without fear. We can go swimming in the nude without looking like a standard lamp, as my husband used to call me. It's like a string hanging. And a sun hat. See, menopause is brilliant. It's really brilliant. It's rather like puberty, only backwards. You know, once you get over the wild mood swings, the hot flushes, and the desperate fear of old age, it's a doddle. And of course, you know, once you get the right treatment as well, and that's really important. And we talk about hot flushes as power surges, and they are. When we're managing menopause, they really are. And what is important, as I said before, is the fact that the world is indeed run by menopausal women. They are. That is why they take no shit from anyone. And in concluding, I want to say how much Remifemin helped me. And I'm now an ambassador for Remifemin. Oh God, how times have changed. Once I would have been an ambassador for Remy Martin. Ladies and gentlemen, please explore the new frontiers of menopause with a pack of Remifemin and a map and a nice bottle of red. And if you have any questions, please feel free to see me after class. Thank you very much for your kind attention.